Welcome to this video about finding micro alphas. In this video, we will explore some ways to find micro alphas in the markets. For finding micro alphas, creativity is an indispensable prerequisite. Looking for alphas where many have looked before is like trying to find gold after the site has already been frequented extensively. It is, of course, important to know a wide suite of mathematical tools, but this is not enough. Often as a novice, creativity is somewhat limited, as often you don't know what you don't know, but after taking steps, more and more ideas will open up to be explored. But can't we simply implement the ideas that are shared by other people? The issue with others' ideas, as mentioned before, is that they have probably been explored extensively already. However, slight modifications even to old ideas can often deliver great results. Today there are countless blogs, videos, and academic papers talking about ideas and sharing insights. It's down to the hard work of the practitioner to separate the good from the bad and add a personal spin to them. Let's do some exploration and see where it takes us. In 2015, Kaku Shadze published a paper with the title 101 Formulaic Alphas, which details a wide range of alpha ideas. For a novice, the ideas in this paper may seem to be quite hard to grasp, but with the experience that you have gathered throughout this course, you can already test most of what is detailed there. Let's have a look at some of them. For a start, let's look at alpha number 3. There are a few things here that we can already recognize. First, we are calculating the cross-sectional ranks for volume and open price. We then determine the correlation coefficient between the two on a 10-period rolling basis. The factor, minus 1, means that this is a mean reverting alpha. The lower the value, the longer our position. In order to make this meaningful, we download a selection of 12 US stocks from different sectors. We are now ready to implement the alpha. You can calculate this alpha by simply using a vectorized operation. And after plotting, the results would look something like this. You would agree that it looks neither consistent nor convincing. We could perhaps do some more exploration with different stocks, or move on to the next alpha. How about alpha number 57? Keep in mind that what we are doing here is taking a long shot, in the hope that some of the alphas we investigate may bear fruit, with no guarantee that they will. Calculating this involves some more vectorized complexity than the previous alpha. First, we calculate the volume-weighted average price. Next, the argmax function tells us which day of the last 30 days of close prices was the highest. This is now ranked and smoothened with a weighted moving average. Finally, we divide the first expression by the second. Here's what the results look like. And these do not look convincing either. Perhaps this is not surprising, since there does not seem to be any economic rationale underlying those alpha formulas. From the paper, we can conclude that these alphas were developed for intraday trading, with a time resolution in the second range. However, the most important point is that we have explored the possibility, and we have learned to implement complex alphas quickly, and with just a few lines of code. That was all for now.